My dear students, today I am going to take about viruses. Viruses are very common nowadays. COVID-19 that causes many damages to human being worldwide. The word virus is derived from Latin meaning poison. So, viruses are poisonous fluid. The poisonous fluid, when come in contact with our body or with any other living organism, that causes disease, that damages the vital organs of our body. The viruses are submicroscopic or ultramicroscopic obligate intracellular parasites. Submicroscopic or ultramicroscopic means they are smaller. They are the smallest organism. They cannot be seen under microscope. They cannot be seen under any ordinary microscope. Only under electron microscope they can be seen. They can be observed, they can be identified. The viruses are submicroscopic particles or electron microscopic particles. They are obligate intracellular parasites. Once the virus enter into any living cells, that will cause disease. That will behave like a parasite. Parasites are organisms. Parasites are living organism which cause disease to other living organism. They are called parasite. Viruses are obligate parasite, always parasite. They cannot function as saprophyte or any other method of living organism. They are obligate intracellular parasite. Only they behave like a parasite only inside the living cell. So that is intracellular parasite. Each virus, any virus, if you take any virus, the virus has nucleic acid surrounded by protein core. Viruses are having two things. Number one, nucleic acid. Number two, protein core. Nucleic acid will be inside, which is surrounded by a protective covering, protein protective covering, that is called protein coat. We have nucleic acid. All the organisms are having nucleic acid. Nucleic acid is of two types, DNA and RNA. DNA deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA is a ribonucleic acid. In all the living organism, both DNA and RNA can be seen. But in viruses, in each virus, either DNA or RNA can be seen. Only RNA or DNA. A virus may have either DNA or RNA. Virology is a separate science which deals with virus. Viruses are biological puzzle. They are considered as a biological puzzle because they cannot be included either in the living organism or in the non-living object. They have both the living characteristic feature and non-living characteristic feature. So, viruses are called biological puzzle. Viruses have both living characteristic feature and non-living characteristic feature. We will see the living characteristic feature of virus. Number one, presence of nucleic acid and protein. All viruses are having nucleic acid and protein. That's the living characteristic feature. Second one, viruses are capable of mutation. Mutation is a sudden changes taking place in any living organism. So it also capable of mutation. Ability to multiply within the living cell. That is the third point. Third characteristic feature. When the viruses enter into any living cell, the viruses will multiply. The multiplication of the cell, multiplication property is a living characteristic feature. They cause disease when they are present in any living being or in any living cell. So that is another characteristic feature. Ability to infect and cause disease in the living beings. Fifth point, they show irritability. Already we have seen what is irritability. That is the response to the external stimuli. That process is called irritability. The viruses also will cause irritability. That is a living characteristic feature of organism. Finally, viruses have host specificity. They will attack a particular organism, that is the host specificity. These are all considered as a living characteristic feature of virus. Come to non-living characteristic feature. Viruses can be crystallized. In the year 1935, W.M. Stanley crystallized the virus from tobacco mosaic juice. So that is the viruses can be crystallized. That is the non-living character of the virus. Here, the metabolism is absent. Absence of metabolism. What is metabolism? Already we have studied metabolism. It's a total physiological function going on inside the cell or inside the living organism. That is the metabolism. It can be divided into anabolism and catabolism. Here, totally metabolism is absent. That is a non-living character. Third point, when they are present outside the host cell, when they are present outside the cell of any organism, they are inactive. So the inactive nature outside the cell of living organism, that is a non-living character. They do not show functional autonomy. Independently, the viruses cannot function. When they are present inside the cell, they will behave like a living organism. They will function actively. When the viruses are present outside the cell, they will be inactive. They will be inert substance like a non-living object. Finally, energy producing enzyme system is absent. We have enzyme system. All the living organisms are having energy producing enzyme system. Electron transport system is there. Through electron transport system, energy is produced. That energy is stored in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So we have energy producing enzyme system. All the living organisms are having energy producing enzyme system. But in the case of viruses, energy producing enzyme system is totally absent. So that these are all the living and non-living characteristic feature of virus. Now we pass on to the milestone in virology. In the year 1796, Edward Jenner used vaccination for smallpox. Already we have studied Edward Jenner identified world famous first vaccine against smallpox. So first vaccine he discovered. The world first vaccine he discovered, that is, in the year 1886, Adolf Meyer demonstrated infectious nature of the tobacco mosaic virus. He collected the infected tobacco mosaic plant and he collected the infected leaf of the tobacco mosaic plant. He extracted juice from the infected leaf, and when he applied the infected juice against the healthy plant, healthy tobacco mosaic plant, immediately disease appeared. So from that he concluded that the tobacco mosaic virus is an infectious one. In the year 1892, Dmitry Ivanovsky proved viruses are smaller than bacteria. He proved that viruses are smaller than the smallest bacteria. So such a very, very small organism can be identified, observed, and can be studied the structure in detail only through electron microscope. In the year 1898, M.W. Bejarin defined viruses as contagium vivum fluidum. According to Latin word, it's a Latin word meaning poison. Contagious vivum fluidum is the definition given by the Bejarin. That means contagium, infectious, vivum, living, fluidum, fluid. That is the meaning for the word contagium vivum fluidum. Infectious, living, fluid. Viruses are infectious, living, fluid. In the year 1915, W.F.W. Taft identified viral infection in bacteria. Bacteria causes disease to all the plants, all the animals, including human being, etc. But the viruses will cause disease to even bacteria. Viruses infecting bacteria, the viruses which cause disease to bacteria, viruses which attack bacteria, they are called bacteriophages. In the year 1950, F.W. Taft identified viral infection in bacteria. In the year 1970, D. Herrille coined the term bacteriophage. The virus which attack bacteria, the virus which infect bacteria, they are called bacteriophage. The bacteriophage name was given by, the term bacteriophage was given by D. Herrille. In the year 1935, W.M. Stanley obtained crystalline protein, sediment from infected tobacco juice. He made the crystals from the infected tobacco juice in the year 1935. He was jointly awarded Nobel Prize in chemistry in the year 1946 with J.H. Northrop. In the year 1984, Luc Montagnier of Pasteur Institute, Paris, and also Robert Gallo of USA discovered HIV, human immunodeficiency virus, for AIDS. That is the virus. It's a group of virus that causes AIDS disease in human being. So that is about the milestone in virology. Come to the size and shape of the virus. First you will see size of the virus. Since the viruses are ultra microscopic particles, they are very, very small. They are very, very small organism. Smallest organism can be seen under electron microscope only. That's why they are called ultra microscopic particles. they are smaller than the smallest bacteria. That is according to Dmitry Ivanovsky proved viruses are smaller than smallest bacteria. The diameter in general, the viruses have 20 to 300 nanometer. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 the power of minus 9 meters. Bacteriophage measures about 10 to 100 nanometer in size. Whereas the tobacco mosaic virus, the size of the tobacco mosaic virus is about 300 to 20 nanometer. And come to the shape of the virus. There are three types of viruses classified based on the shape. Number one, cuboid symmetry. Number two, helical symmetry. Number three, complex or atypical symmetry. Cuboid symmetry, example adenovirus, herpes virus. Helical symmetry, influenza virus, tobacco mosaic virus, etc. Complex or atypical symmetry, example bacteriophage, vaccinia virus. In the page number 5, figure 1.4, diagrams given for adenovirus, tobacco mosaic virus and bacteriophage. According to the shape of the virus, three types example given. First one, adenovirus. Adenovirus having cuboidal structure with protein coat that includes nucleic acid DNA. So centrally, DNA has a nucleic acid present, which is surrounded by a protective layer, protein coat, and from that fibers are projected out. So that's a very simple structure, adenovirus. Tobacco mosaic virus. It is a long, elongated helical virus, rod-shaped virus that contain RNA as the nucleic acid, which is surrounded by protein coat. The name of the protein coat is capsid. The protein coat consists of a number of subunits. Each subunit is called capsomer. This is the capsomer. So, all collectively called capsid, one subunit is called capsomer. Come to the bacteriophage, T4 bacteriophage. It is a asymmetrical complex or atypical or asymmetrical virus. There is no particular shape. It is tadpole shaped one. T4 bacteriophage is a tadpole shaped one. Consisting of a head, neck, tail and tail fibers. The head is hexagonal, consisting of protein coat that include DNA as a nucleic acid. Inside the protein coat, there is a nucleic acid that is DNA. Just below the head, there is a narrow neck surrounded by collar, and that is connected with the tail, with the tail sheath. And the tail sheath, at the end of the tail sheath, there is a basal plate to which two structures are given, two structures are produced. One is a tail pin. This is the tail pin. There are six tail pins and six tail fibers produced from the basal plate. So these are all the very simple structure of adenovirus, tobacco mosaic virus and T4 bacteriophage. So far today, now we have seen about the general structure, introduction about the viruses, milestone in virology, size and shape of the virus, and diagrammatic structure we have seen given in the page number 4, figure 1.4. That is all about general structure of virus.